when I woke up this morning at 7, I was getting picked up at 7:45. Patrick, my fiancé, tried to pull me by my waist over this morning in bed, and I was like, no, baby, we don't got time for that this morning. I got to get to the prayer breakfast, and I got to be on time, and a little TMI, but he can wait. I'll see him later tonight.
That was Republican Congresswoman Nancy Mace telling a story about her sex life at a prayer breakfast. And it was specifically a prayer breakfast for Tim Scott, who of course is running for president of the United States. And perhaps she was trying to distance herself from Scott, who is unfortunately notorious for being a virgin for a really long time, although I don't really care about that. But nonetheless, she's getting called all sorts of terrible names by conservatives right now.
Of course.
For doing that, because they're fiancés and they think, oh my God, I believe that there might be premarital sex happening in this establishment.
Like, what? You don't say.
Yeah.
Look, conservatives, you serious, dog? Really? You think that people should not have sex before marriage? You're gonna go with that. Okay, have at it. Tell everybody. The right wing position, the Republican position is no sex before marriage. No sex ever outside of marriage. Okay? That is, well, that's, you know, your Christian fundamentalist position.
Right.
Please run on that in every election. I encourage you as much as I possibly can.
So let's get into Scott, because I do remember talking about this a little bit on the show previously, and dude definitely engages in premarital sex. So
they're all liars, guys. They're all, none of them believe it. They all have sex as soon as they possibly can. They have had sex over and over again. They have sex in all the ways they tell you not to have it.
Listen, listen. I'm not telling anyone to go sleep around, right? That's not the message I'm trying to send here. However, if you are seriously considering marrying someone, it is an obligation, a responsibility to have premarital sex. The idea that you're gonna marry someone that you have not been intimate with yet, that is an important part of a marriage.
Yeah,
look, for a few months and then it's not.
Oh, that's hilarious.
I'm kidding.
For all America. All right, no, seriously guys, think about it. I got married at 38. I was supposed to sit around like an idiot and not have any sex until the age of 38. And what part of this is freedom? Republicans are like, we're the party of freedom, okay? But don't do this, don't do that, and don't do the most human thing in the world until you explode. Okay, well, kind of literally. Trust me, it'll happen. And it has happened for them. Anyway, it doesn't matter, they're all liars. So here, I give credit to Nancy Mace.
Do you?
Because no, she was being honest for a second.
But why? Okay, so hold on. We jumped ahead into discussing conservatism and how we disagree with this notion that you shouldn't have premarital sex. But can we just go back and address the fact that she felt the need to say that?
At a prayer breakfast.
But why? Yeah, but why? Why'd you do that? I mean, look.
No, you know why? She was being human for a second, and she forgot she's a politician, and she forgot she's on the right.
She had her fiancé on her mind. She's like, God, I should have went back to bed just for like a few minutes, you know?
No,
like,
she definitely had it on her mind, and I give her credit for that. Like, okay, she likes the guy, she's into it, she has a healthy relationship. I mean, that's just better than most great majority of Republican politicians. But if you make the mistake of being honest as a politician, why does nobody ever do it? Because everybody always attacks you, right? And if you're a right winger, God help you. I mean, if you go 1% outside of what you're supposed to do morally, they're gonna obliterate you. So she made the mistake of being honest.
So Florida congressional candidate Laverne Spicer attacked her, saying that's some, can we use this word on air?
I think.
That's some ho talk. Is it though? Is it ho talk? I mean, she's literally engaged to a guy that she's monogamous with. How is she a ho? Like, what?
Is that what Republicans are telling us? Everyone who has sex with their fiancés is a prostitute? Okay, to say it in every election, please. She's not even single and dating. It's her fiancé. And apparently that makes you a hoe, according to the right wing. Please say it in every election.
Yeah, Tim Young, here's your daily reminder that Nancy Mace is trash.
Trash okay. Referring to having sex with your fiance that you're gonna get married to.
Yep.
Trash. Mm-hmm. Like, they're calling the whole country trash.
The founder of DC Inquirer, Brandon Gill, says, imagine the level of disdain one must have for Christians to smile and say this at a prayer breakfast. Look, honestly, I would not have engaged in that conversation or shared that information at a prayer breakfast. I do think there's a time and place, and it was a weird thing to mention there. But like, I don't think that it means that she has disdain for Christians. She just had a weird lapse in judgment.
And guys, all of this talk is nonsense. None of the Christians do it either. Like 3% of them do it. The rest of them are all lying. They have all the sex in the world. They have it before marriage, during marriage, after marriage.
Listen, either they're banging or hoping and wishing and praying that they'd be banging. Like that's just reality, it's human nature. The idea that someone is inherently like a bad person because they engage in premarital sex is crazy to me. And especially if you're engaged to someone, you're obligated, absolute requirement to test drive the car before you buy it.
But good news, the 1200s called, they'd like their policies back. So
yeah,
every American does what you say is awful and trash and what a prostitute would do. So good luck trying to make that case to the American people.
Now Mace, in response to all of the backlash, has put out her own statement about this. I go to church because I'm a sinner, not a saint. Glad those in attendance, including Senator Tim Scott and my pastor, oh my God, your pastor was there, took this joke in stride. Pastor Greg and I will have extra to talk about on Sunday.
Crying emoji, crying laughing emoji.
Yeah.
So look, I like that. That was spicy, and she's not backing down from it.
No, that's great. She shouldn't back down from it.
And just to clarify what Anna said earlier about Tim Scott. So Tim Scott is a very Christian and right wing Republican from South Carolina, and he was not married for a long time, and he doesn't believe in premarital sex. So at some point, a reporter asked him. I think this was like a decade ago. We covered a little while back, because the issue came back up since he's running for president. And it turns out, no, of course he was having sex before marriage.
In 2012, Scott laughed when asked recently about whether as a 46-year-old bachelor, he adheres to the same virtues that he did at 30. And he would go to schools and give lectures and talks on how you should abstain until marriage. And here's how he responded, yeah, not as well as I did then, he said in his Capitol Hill office. Cause he'd be banging and he should be, he's 46 years old. Like what, you want him to be a 46-year-old virgin? Which by the way, if you happen to be a virgin at 46, like no judgment, but that's not the ideal situation for most people, right?
Look, if you're doing it voluntarily, I think you're mental and totally throwing your life away. Go live your life. Some rabbi said that 2,500 years ago, and he didn't know what the hell was going on either. Okay, this is the year 2023. If you decide that you're gonna throw away this life because you think there might be another life where you and your religion and your interpretation of your religion wins out over all the other religions and all the other interpretations, and then so you get rewarded in a second life maybe, and that's why you're throwing away this life? Listening to a bunch of idiot liars who never practice what they say anyway? Wake up, man, wake up. And go have sex with somebody, please.
Yeah, responsibly, of course.
And with consent, right-wingers, with consent. Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun, but you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.